Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel for our next video celebrating the Not2Shabby new release. I'm going to be playing with this amazing fall set. So it's a fall explosion on your card. There was a part of me that thought, are you doing too much, Mary? And then I was like, no, it's fall and all things are great in fall. So here is the stamp set that I'm going to be using. This is adorable and so much fun. So I'm going to first do some masking, okay, because I want a bunch of leaves on this card panel. I'm going to be using Bristol smooth cardstock because I'm going to be coloring with Arteza real brush pens, and I'm going to be using this Nocturne ink from Versafine Clair because it is waterproof. I'm also using my favorite masking paper, and it's basically sticker paper that you can get in bulk, and it works amazingly well, and it's more cost affordable at the end of the day. So I'm going to be using that, and I'm going to just be masking. So I put a couple of the stamps down, a couple of the leaves first, so that there are some in the forefront of the card panel and not everything was falling behind each other. So I put three of those down, then I'm masking them, then I am stamping. So just be careful. It's hard to see sometimes with the lines, which making sure you mask them. So just watch what you're doing and be careful. There we are so far, but I want some more. So I'm going to go back in and I'm going to mask off some more. I made four masks, I think, for this one. This way I wouldn't make that mistake of forgetting and just totally ruining that piece of it. So going through, I left this in here because I wanted you to see the process of masking. Sometimes I skip through that, but this time I left it in, and I left in all the coloring. So I will have to find something to talk to you about today because there is a lot of coloring. But I had so much fun with it, and it's been a while since I've put this kind of effort into coloring a background. And this is my take on a scene card, or building a scene, if you will. So let's get to it. Okay, I am using, like I said, Bristol Smooth, waterproof ink, and I'm using Arteza Real Brush Pens. Now these Real Brush Pens, if you are familiar with them, they are a lot like the Zig Clean Color Real Brush Pens. There are other brands that are made similar to this as well. I love Arteza because they're more affordable. I do have the 96 set of the Artezas, so I'm a huge fan of them. A little ink goes a long way, and you can blend the colors together beautifully, or you can use water to pull them out. So I do a mixture of both. Mostly on this card, the reason why the colors are so vibrant is because I didn't use a whole lot of the water blending technique. I used a lot of the markers together. And so you're just building up that color. A couple tips when you're doing this, if you're using this technique, is if you are putting a light color down onto a dark color, have a piece of paper towel or paper off to the side so you can scratch off some of that dark color that you're picking up with the lighter color, just like I did there with the yellow. And so I'm just kind of wiping that off a little bit if it gets a little bit too muddy or too much of that dark color goes onto the light brush. So just being aware of that when you're coloring, it'll keep the truest color for your image on here. Now, when I went into my stash of Arteza markers, I pulled out the most fall-like colors. I did not write them down. I just grabbed the ones I thought, and then as I went through this process, I grabbed even more. So when I'm talking about fall colors, I'm looking for some things that are rustic, such as like a burnt orange, a maroon, different shades of green, yellow. Any yellow is really fine. Also, I picked some pinks, just like one pink that almost had like a reddish, orangish hue. So I used that one as well. But just any colors that are earth toned. I didn't want to go for, you know, of course you want to stay away from the bright blues and the, you know, neon colors, unless that's the look you're going for. But if you're going for more of an earthy, rustic color, that's what you're going to want to. I also added some browns because in the leaves there are browns, as you can see what I'm playing with right here. So yeah, okay. So while I'm coloring that up, you can kind of just watch the process. This one I did use the water brush on, but I think I only used the water brush for like two. So let's see, what can I update you on the happenings of my life at this moment? Well, things are going well with the kids. They're loving school. Adia said to me the other day, she counted the amount of school days she had left. And I was like, wow, already? You're already counting? You want to be done? She goes, no, I don't want to be done. I thought that was a turn of events. So that's fantastic. But I also know she's going to middle school here next year for sixth grade. And so she's nervous about that prospect because, she's may or may not have all of her friends go with her. It's just a change. So she's thinking about it already. But update on her, I have to tell you, that little one inspires me. So quick story, she last year was brand new to the school, and 2 weeks in, we had a rough start. We'll just say that. Had a rough start. She left all her friends in Florida, and she just, it takes a while to get acclimated and used to new people. But about 2 weeks in, she came home and said she was going to run for vice president because the fourth grader is the vice president, the fifth grader is the president of the school. And I was like, oh, that's great. Let's do it. So I helped her with her little campaign. And it came down to the final two, and she was in the final two. And then she did not get selected. So she did not get voted for in as the vice president. She came home. We had the conversation about what does that look like as the supporting role? You can't just not get it and pout. You have to figure out how you're also going to contribute because you wanted to run for vice president. So, that there's something to be said about that. So, what kind of service can you provide, to the school? So, she was selected for the Senate. Now, you have to understand, we live right near Washington, D.C., so the government student body is very strong in this school. I never had that growing up. I didn't know what a Senate was. So, anyway, she's part of the Senate. This year, she came home and she said, I'm thinking about running for president this year for fifth grade. And I was like, awesome. That sounds great. But she said, but I don't think I'm going to. And I said, well, why not? And she said, I don't know. I said, do you want to be president? And she said, yes. I said, well, then let's talk about why you don't want to run. And she said, because I'm afraid of losing. I said, okay, that's fair. I get that. That's a fair statement. I said, but don't let fear get in your way. One of my favorite quotes is everything you want is on the other side of fear. And so we talked about it. I talked her through it ish. I said, but this decision is completely up to you. I want you to make this decision, and I don't want you to think of me or, your dad or your brother. This is your decision to make, and we will support you no matter what you decide. And she came back to me a couple days later and said, I'm going to run for president. Oh, I was like, well, let me take a page from this little one's playbook because she just inspires me. So I'm super proud of her. We're excited. We're going to be campaigning. Oh, it's going to be fun. And I hope she wins. But if she doesn't, we'll talk that through as well. Okay. So you can see, back to the card here. I'm still coloring. I chose three very different pumpkins because I thought that was going to be super fun. I've seen the green ones, and I love the yellow hues that you have in those green pumpkins. They're so pretty. The first pumpkin I did was slightly too red, a little reddish orangey. The second pumpkin and the orange one I thought came out perfectly, and then I'm really loving this green one. So I get those colored up. We're going to go back to the card panel because I'm going to add some grass behind these leaves, and then I'm going to add a sky. So I just do the same thing, except I'm going in with the green and the water brush for both the grass and the sky. Turning my paper so it's easier for me to color, I'm going to hit that card panel with some of this bright blue color. And this is going to allow me to pull up. Now, if I had to do this again, I would say start on one side and then pull your water brush up and work your way down instead of covering it completely all the way across because I feel like it was a little bit hard to blend when I got to the end. It's possible that it dried a little bit too much. So, to avoid that, next time I would take my water brush and kind of just work my way halfway through the card panel and then back. So it's not bad, it's just it didn't blend as much in some spots. And you'll see as we go. So I'm just touching that water. Now be careful with this leaf at the top. I did get a tiny bit of bleeding from that color. These inks are water reactive even after a while of drying. So although they're not fully dried, or although even that leaf might be fully dry, you're still going to be able to move it a tiny bit. Okay, so then I'm going to heat set this, and I'm loving the way this is coming out. I feel like the boldness of these colors just makes me happy. I want to jump in these leaves. So, okay, I'm going to lay down flat the two, the green one and the orange reddish pumpkin, and then pop up the bright orange in the front, or I guess not bright, you know, the one in the front. I'm going to take some stickles because I thought this would be super fun to add a little bit of accent to the pumpkins, almost like a little glitter accent to both of them. And then I'm just going to put my card panel down on my card base, and we're calling this a day. I used the sentiment on there, happy pumpkin spice season. And that'll finish up our fall cards. So I'm having so much fun with this release. Tomorrow's card, or the next card in the series, will be the winter card from one of the stamp sets. So that'll be a lot of fun. I'll link everything I used below this video. Let me know if you have any questions. And don't forget to use coupon code MARY10 over at the Not2Shabby shop so that you can get 10% off your order. I will see you all in the next video. Have a wonderful week. Bye-bye.